Okay, Mr. Peter, it's once again Friday at Union Square, and I guess the most appropriate thing to talk about now is an update. Where the heck we're at and where we're going. As it is September 22nd, and up in the hinterlands where we live, by this time we could actually have a frost. However, right now we're enjoying a fantastic 80. Today was about 79 degrees up there, and looking at the 10-day forecast, we're going to be in the 80s until next Thursday, which is unprecedented in the opposite direction, because 2 weeks ago we were talking about 37 degrees and highs in the 60s. So what happened this last week is now all of a sudden our peppers, our tomatoes, our eggplants started growing again. And so we have a lot more of them, as you can see over my shoulder over there. But at the same time, the greens that we planted for the fall are starting to come in despite the heat. One of the good reasons is you've got, basically, you still have short nights, so things cool off. It's been relatively dry. So when it's dry, things stay cooler as opposed to when things are humid. So we're having kind of the best of both worlds. We're getting a lot of nice radishes and greens and so on, but we're also having some spectacular tasting peppers and eggplants this time of year. But I have a funny feeling that after Thursday, once we start hitting October 1st, you know, we're probably going to be staying in those 60s and 40s. And if it stays 60s and 40s, that's still pretty darn good for this time of year, especially if we can avoid that first frost. We still have plenty of summer crops out there, especially in the high tunnels. We've got our beans and other crops that definitely need heat and long days. That's the other problem that we can't do anything with now, because every day we're losing about 2 minutes a day. So in a week's time, you lose 15 minutes of daylight. So that continues until, of course, December 21st, the shortest day. And then after that, believe it or not, the days start getting longer again, but you know, you don't really feel that until you get into March or so up our way.
Yeah. So how do the greens come back?
Well, new plantings for one. Also, old plantings will be reinvigorated by the cool weather. Hot weather kind of shuts them down. Kind of like Peter, when it's 98 degrees, what happens to him?
I need to sit down.
Exactly, and you wilt. Exactly, same thing happens to them. So it shuts them down, they don't really want to grow. And so when the cool weather comes back, they literally start growing. But then we also have, we grow successions. So every 2 to 3 weeks, we're planting a new succession. So the succession that comes up in the cool weather comes up much nicer than, say, an old plant. Got it, Peter?
Yes, sir.
All right.
We're going to look at peppers?
Real sure we can look at peppers. And you get, well, this is a sign of, when you start getting wrinkled, they're losing water. This is like very, very ripe. It'll be very, very sweet, despite the fact that it's, you know, doesn't look so appetizing, but this will be your tastiest pepper.
Okay.
These are? We've gone over these many times.
Bombs.
These are cherry bombs.
Yes.
Your favorite dish is this with chicken.
Yes.
See?
Pollo Diablo or something.
Pollo Diablo.
Or something like that.
These
are called bird's eye.
Bird's eye?
Yeah. I mean, that's one of the names for it, bird's eye.
And these are hot.
And then, they are hot. And these are your classic Spanish padron peppers.
Uh-huh.
Of course, there's only a few of them. They're masquerading as bird's eye.
Okay.
Fatali. And they are kind of fatal.
They're fatal also.
They're very, 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 very hot.
Very hot.
Yep. Cayenne.
Aha.
Cayenne peppers right there.
Cayenne.
It's called Aji Amarillo.
Aji Amarillo.
Even though the color is red, they're still called Aji Amarillo.
Ahi Amarillo. Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Those things are Scotch bonnets.
Scotch bonnets.
So we started growing Scotch bonnets because everybody asked for them. Extremely hot. Extremely hot. Okay. These are masquerading as Scotch bonnets. These are Ahi Dulces.
Wait. Show them again. Put them on my hand. All right.
Ahi dulcis. These guys.
Now you were talking about these last
week.
These
are very, very, they're not very hot, or if any heat at all, they're very aromatic.
They're aromatic. Okay. Should they be with the bonnets or no?
No, they really shouldn't be. But it's late in the day and we're not moving them.
Okay, these?
They're called Flaming is the variety, so they're Fresno, or a Fresno pepper. They're back, the heat brought them back.
Uh-huh.
2 weeks of heat really brought all the peppers and even eggplants, although they're gone by now. These are Bangkok, they're a Thai pepper.
Yes.
You can see the guys put the names in there.
Yes.
To remind me.
Yes.
And I think we've exhausted the peppers on this side.
Okay, wait, what are these?
Those are lemon drop.
Lemon drop. They're
citrusy and fiery.
Citrus and fire.
Yes.
Okay. And these?
And those are poblanos. So
poblanos.
They're hot.
Yeah.
And this one variety is called Tiburon, which I guess in Spanish means sharp.
Okay. And these?
These are a new variety that I can't remember. They're an ahi something. This is a Pan Am variety that was given to us. Extremely sweet. You know, they look hot, but they're not. Okay, uh-huh. And so these are just mini bells.
Uh-huh.
And those are mini bells, just different colors of mini bells.
So it's really easy to confuse these things.
Yes, very easy. These are Antohi Romanian. They're a Hungarian Romanian type. Very thick walled, excellent flavor. And then over here we got all kinds of peppers. Everything from Corno di Toros to mini bells to regular bell peppers. You know, to Japanese. This is a yellow Cubanelle. It's elongated, but it has lobes just like a regular pepper.
Uh-huh.
And all those are just regular, mostly regular bell peppers. The pointed ones are all in the Corno di Toro type.
Italian frying pan. Peppers.
And eggplants.
And then eggplants. Alright, so these are. And these?
These are just purple bell peppers, black bell peppers.
Okay.
Green bell peppers, yellow bell peppers.
Okie doke.
Every kind of yellow bell pepper.
Thank you. All right.
It's really sweet. Sweeter than me.
Yeah, it's sour.
This would go perfectly with the basil that right there.
What are you going to cook with that?
Probably pad gra pao or possibly lap. But I put chili in everything.
Peter, it's been a pleasure again.
Okay.
Keep up the good work. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you at the market.
See you at the market.
Thank you.
Behave.
Always. Thank you.
You're welcome.